I'm David Hale, co-founder of Night and Hale Game Calls. Spent all my life in the outdoors. One of the things that I think is very interesting I want to share with you today, in my latter years, and I'm reaching past the mid-50s, reaching the latter 60s, early 60s, I began to realize how important it was to speak on behalf of a Christian testimony. One of the things that's excited me a lot is across the nation, there seems to be an outpouring of people wanting to put on game suppers, Christian fellowship for men game suppers, and of course women and children were invited too, but the exciting part about it was I got asked to speak at some of those. And one of the interesting things that happened to me, I went to Louisville, Kentucky one year to do my first one, and I thought they was asking me to come up and as a personality in the hunting industry to do a little game calling and show them how to call up a turkey, how to call up a deer. And when I got there, I had a couple of guys ask me if I'd go back in the back room and pray with them over what my speech was to be that night. And I said, well, sure, I can use all the prayer that anybody can give me. So we went back to the room, and next thing you know, these guys were praying, and wasn't short period of time, they were both crying, tears running down their eyes, and I got emotional just listening to them and watching them, but I was thankful that they were praying for me. And when it got done, I said, fellas, I said, I'm missing something here. I said, what's the deal? And one of them said, well, I don't think you quite understand. Tonight, there's about 400 people here at this meeting, and I've got five or six relatives out here who've never been in church before. I got Uncle Bob and Brother Gene, and he went off listening to who all they were, and he said, they don't know Jesus. They've never been in church before. And I said right then, I said, man, this is an awesome responsibility that has been given to me here. I had to change my whole speech right then, and I realized that I was there for another reason other than just showing people how to call up a turkey, how to call up a deer. And I think the interesting thing is that in the outdoors, there's at least 16 million hunters out here. And we got one thing in common. We all like the same sport. But the one thing we don't have in common, everybody doesn't like God and have never made a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. So the harvest is ripe. We have a common bond to get together because we like the outdoors. But at the same time, this has given me an opportunity to tell folks that Jesus is Savior. And one of the interesting things about me speaking at some of these dinners in the last couple of years is I had a fellow tell me here not long ago, and I asked him who spoke last year and who spoke the year before and what did they have to say, and I just wanted to see if I was on tune to what was supposed to be done. He says, well, the other speakers were good, but the difference between you and them was they spoke 90% about how talented they were and 10% about Jesus, and you've come here speaking 90% about Jesus and only showing about 10% of your talent. And I said, what did I do wrong? And he said, no, there's a whole lot of folks here that are touched to know that a person in your area who is in household name in the hunting industry would stand up and give his testimony for Jesus Christ is pretty important. And I began to realize more and more that, hey, this is something to be proud of, not something to be ashamed of. And because I realized that we can pull a lot of folks in the outdoors together with a common bond of wild game and wild game suppers and just hunting in general, that we also can tell them about Jesus, and the harvest is white, it's ripe, it's just ready for the pickings, and I encourage each of you to get involved in any kind of way you can to offer an opportunity to get non-Christians, especially in the hunting world, into your assembly group some kind of way. And I think one of the testimonies I'll end here with is if you look in the first chapter, the 20th verse of Romans, you'll find that there is a place there where it says that God created the world, and because he did, we who partake in it are without excuse for not knowing him. So this is a big burden for us as Christian outdoorsmen to let folks know, hey, you're looking at the tree, man didn't build that. You're looking at the water, man didn't build that. There's a reason for us to be there. There's a glorious part of this outdoors, and the whole thing has to do with the fact that we don't have any excuse for looking at that creation out there and not knowing Jesus as our Savior. So once again, the harvest is ripe, and I want to wish you folks luck at your outreach program in whatever town that you're in.